Here are Daily Tribune's top 5 trending stories for the week. We're starting the list with a showbiz story. Young Kapamilya actress Maris Racal finally confirmed her relationship with OPM icon Rico Blanco, saying that they are happy together. Romantic rumors involving the two hit the headlines last March when Maris greeted the musician on his birthday. Many supported the two despite sharing a 25-year age gap. Rico is 48 while Maris is 23. In 2018, Maris sought Rico's creative input for music, and in 2019, they worked together in the song Abot Langit. Coming at number 4, Manila Mayor Isko Moreno asked the Interagency Task Force to consider scrapping its policy of requiring the public to wear face shields outside their homes. He said the national government should instead require the use of face shields in the hospitals to reduce the expenses of the public. Moreno added that the Philippines might be the only country in the world that requires the wearing of face shields in the streets. However, in the latest press briefing in Malacañang, presidential spokesperson Harry Roque rejected the idea, saying that the government would only abide by the recommendation of infectious diseases expert Dr. Edsel Salvana, who has claimed that wearing of a face mask and a face shield protect a person from acquiring COVID-19 by 90%. At number 3, Philippine National Police Chief General Guillermo Eleazar has ordered the filing of charges and the initiation of dismissal proceedings against Police Master Sgt. Hensie Zinampan, who was behind the cold-blooded murder of a woman in Quezon City. Zinampan was a drunk policeman who was caught on video while shooting 52-year-old Lilibet Valdez along an alley in Barangay Greater Fairview at around 9:30 p.m. on Monday. Zinampan is an active policeman assigned at the PNP Police Security Protection Group. Despite this, Eleazar assured the public that good police officers outnumbered a few bad eggs in the organization. Next up, at number 2, the National Council of the ruling PDP-Laban has adopted a resolution convincing President Rodrigo Duterte to run for Vice President in the 2022 elections. During the council's meeting in Cebu on Monday, PDP-Laban Vice Chairman Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi approved the motion of Party Vice President for External Affairs Raul Lambino to adopt the resolution. The same resolution urges Mr. Duterte to choose his running mate in the next year's elections. Presidential spokesperson Harry Roque, however, said Mr. Duterte's decision to run in the next year's elections would depend on divine intervention. And taking the first spot this week is the story about the latest controversy involving the most popular fast food chain in the country and its alleged deep-fried towel. Jollibee Foods Corporation ordered a 3-day closure of its Bonifacio Global City franchise store following reports that a customer has allegedly received fried towel instead of fried chicken. In a statement, the management said that it has already directed the branch to close for 3 days starting June 3 to thoroughly review its compliance with procedures and retrain its store team to ensure that this will not happen again. The incident occurred last Tuesday evening. Jollibee also assured that it will send out reminders to all stores to ensure the strict adherence to its food preparation system. And that's it for Daily Tribune's Top 5 Trending Stories for the week.